The F-15EX is pure sex when it's bristling with 12 missiles, though setups with as many as 16 AMRAAMs have also been toyed with. It's definitely the most heavily armed US Air Force fighter around. The F-22 usually carries 8 missiles, 6 of those being AMRAAMs, and in theory, if stealth was no concern, it could carry more. Though in practice, there haven't been any photos of trials with more than 2 externally carried AMRAAMs. But there's more to the F-15EX than just the number of missiles. For a more in-depth look at just what's the logic behind buying jets whose brethren started their US Air Force career 45 years ago, watch our whole video. Modern jets require secure data links, so the enemy can't intercept their communications or locate them, which is pretty much what NordVPN, sponsoring this video, also does. But for your private internet connection. Whether you use a mobile device or a computer, NordVPN creates a private virtual route between your device and the internet. That route can be redirected through any of the 59 countries that you pick. So if you need to connect from Canada or Albania, for example, you can. There are over 5,300 servers to pick from. Of course, NordVPN encrypts your connection for added safety. You can install it on Windows, Android, iOS, macOS, or Linux devices. Even Android TV is supported, and Binkov viewers are getting a special offer. Go to nordvpn.com/Binkov and use the code Binkov, or simply click below for the link to the offer. When you purchase a 2-year plan, you'll get a bonus gift with a huge discount. NordVPN can keep you safe. Try it out! On to our video. The F-15EX is the newest Strike Eagle variant. Basically the most advanced F-15 there is, and the US Air Force requested purchase of the first 8 airframes in 2019. This year, first such Eagles, now officially nicknamed Eagle 2s, have been delivered. The US Air Force's original plan calls for 144 F-15EX planes to be delivered over the course of the next 10 to 12 years. With those, the plan is to replace the F-15C fleet, currently some 200-ish airframes strong. Even though the F-15EX has 2 seats, the US Air Force plans to fly them with just 1 pilot, as their main role is air superiority. Though the planes do retain all the hardware to allow them to be used for strike missions as well. The original contract, however, contains options to procure as many as 200 Eagle 2s. Whether that will happen, we will not likely know for several more years. While the US Air Force is happy with the F-35's capabilities, and while the F-35 was originally slated to replace even the F-15s, in recent years it has become apparent the long-term budget can't maintain both large-scale purchases of F-35s per year, as well as maintenance of all those F-35s. The latter is the main sticking point, as F-35s have been proving to be very costly to operate and maintain. So even though the new F-15EX costs as much as a new F-35, due to lower operating costs and due to lower unit conversion costs, the F-35 will now not be replacing that many old F-15s. Indeed, if the 200 plane option is exercised, the F-35s may not replace any air superiority F-15 unit. Furthermore, back in 2018, there were Air Force studies suggesting that the F-15EX might even be the plane of choice to replace the Strike Eagles. Currently, the Air Force operates some 200 F-15Es, which are now some 30 years old. While they don't need as urgent replacement as the C and D fighter models, they will also need to be addressed sometime in the 2030s. Some weeks ago, a bombshell piece of news was released, saying that the F-22 is to be retired from the year 2030 onward. So there will be many planes to replace in a fairly short time frame. The future 6th generation fighter, which is to start its service by 2030, will evidently first be replacing the Raptor fleet, and then possibly expand to other units. Whether those will be older F-15s or even F-16 units that haven't converted to the F-35 yet is unknown. But in such a course of events, especially if F-35 costs can't be controlled, it might not be implausible that even more F-15EX planes will be bought. Perhaps as many as 400, as that 2018 Air Force study suggested. So with up to 200 or even 400 new Eagles en route, the Air Force might rely on that 1970s design for decades and decades to come. Indeed, the Eagle II has a proclaimed airframe lifespan of a whopping 20,000 flight hours. That translates to some 90 years of usage, in theory. The Air Force may very well sell their planes off to other countries before that. But the plan does seem to indicate using those new Eagles for decades to come. So does their procurement make sense? Actually, yeah. First off, they're not fully 1970s designs. Yes, the overall layout is very much unchanged from the original. So much so that it's hard to tell an F-15EX apart from an old F-15 two-seater. Here's a hint though, the fairings on the top of vertical tails are identical on the new Eagle. Older Eagles had one fairing visibly bigger. There are of course many other small changes like on the intakes and the fairings near the engines, which now house new sensors. Finally, the long-standing issue of the US Air Force using engines without the so-called turkey feathers on their Eagles has been rectified. The engine nozzles have a different look. That's because the new Eagles do use new engines. Old Eagles and Strike Eagles used Pratt & Whitney engines. Eagles too are so far flying with a different General Electric set of engines. Future airframes may get different engines. So what else is new in these Eagle 2s? They have a new cockpit, with a new heads-up display and big 10x19-inch displays in both cockpits. Basically a more modern cockpit than the F-22 has and similar to the F-35 one. In 2020, the Air Force issued a request for a new helmet-mounted display model to be used in the F-15EX. It is to be as good or better as JHMCS, the US current helmet display of choice, while reducing weight. The Eagle 2 also has a new mission computer, ADCP-2, allegedly the fastest one ever installed on any US fighter jet. Perhaps the biggest change is that the avionics are based on open mission systems architecture. That's something even the F-22 doesn't have. Modernizing the Eagle 2 and adding capabilities in the future will be quicker and more frequent. The radar itself is capable but nothing extraordinary. It is the same AESA radar that the modernized Strike Eagles are getting. Still, it's a big and capable array, very likely trailing in some capabilities ever so slightly only behind the F-35's radar and maybe the F-22's radar. Eagles can also carry a targeting pod on a separate hardpoint. But since the EX will most often perform air superiority missions, such targeting pods will seldom be carried. Importantly, the self-defense arrays have been replaced all around the plane as new ones are part of the EPAS system. It integrates all the radar warning and electronic signal geolocation capabilities with the defensive measures, such as chaff and flares, which coincidentally have received bigger containers, for 50% more such decoys to be carried into the fight. So far there is no word on possible towed decoy options. Also curiously, there is no mention of missile approach warning sensors. While advanced Eagles meant for export, such as Qatari or Saudi ones, do have those sensors, the US Eagles observed so far do not have them. However, the mounting points for such sensors are present, so there may be some future sensor perhaps better than those in Expert Eagles in the cards. Something similar to sensors in the F-35 might be plausible. Such sensors are crucial to a modern plane, not just for getting a precise warning about incoming missiles, but also for maintaining situational awareness around the plane. Modern systems such as those in the F-35 are also used for tracking various faraway contacts. But perhaps the biggest reason why the Air Force is pursuing newly built Eagles in the first place is weapons options. Older Eagles always had two hardpoints under each wing, but due to the old analog flight control system, carrying stuff on the outer points interfered with the plane's stability. Since the new Eagle has computerized controls, that fly-by-wire system compensates for the issues on its own. In practice, that means four more missiles carried by the Eagle in air-to-air combat, or additional air-to-ground weaponry. While there have been various images of the Eagles brimming with missiles published, it's far from assured that any Eagle will indeed be carrying extra AMRAAMs instead of fuel tanks under the wings, but in theory that option might be there. There have also been images of double AMRAAM racks under the fuselage. Again, how realistic is that remains to be seen, but it's a potential option, and the F-15EX does seem to be about just that, options. If there is one plane that can do the missile truck role well, flying close to stealth jets and aiding in the fight by spamming the enemy with far more missiles than stealth planes would carry, it's the Eagle. The Eagle is big enough and carries enough fuel so it can pull off such big warloads and still achieve acceptable performance. Indeed, with 3 drop tanks and 2 conformal tanks, it can carry almost 35,000 pounds of fuel. With such a fuel load, the older, clean F-15 could achieve ferry range far greater than the F-35. So even a heavily laden F-15 could still likely keep up with the current stealth jets. Also, its speed means it can add a bit of performance to the unit of otherwise speed-limited F-35s, offering certain added tactical options. Very importantly, sometimes large weapons are needed. Those may be large cruise missiles, very large bunker-busting bombs, or even very long-range air-to-air missiles. The F-22 and F-35 can't carry those internally, and if they carry them externally, their stealth gets ruined. So if a part of the overall US Air Force fleet within some mission has to carry such weapons, then it only makes sense for that part of the fleet to be the high-performance and cheaper-to-operate Eagles than the F-35s, for example. The F-15EX and the modernized Strike Eagles may thus be the platform of choice to carry oversized weapons, like the Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile, which also features a large warhead. Or the big laser-guided paveways, like the 2,000-pound paveway laser-guided bombs, which the F-35s can't carry internally. Or the 5,000-pound GBU-28, which the F-35 can't use at all. Finally, there is the issue of the new outsized air-to-air missile. The 2020 Air Force budget talking points explicitly mentioned the F-15EX can carry an outsized air-to-air weapon. While no such missile has yet been revealed, the Air Force has been warning for years that the Chinese are outgunning it when it comes to long-range missiles. Indeed, US officials like General Herbert in 2015 were saying that the Chinese PL-15 missile has a great range and that the US must be able to outmatch that range. In 2019, General Plius said the AMRAAM has a range in excess of 50 miles, but to counter the PL-15, the US needs something far more capable, and that he'd love the US to get a missile with a range of over 150 miles. The thing is, while the AMRAAM successor in development, the AIM-260, may indeed approach such figures, that may still not be enough to outgun the other big Chinese missile, one observed at the end of 2016, which is almost 6 meters long and might have a range in excess of 200 miles. Such weapons have no hope of being fitted inside an F-22 or F-35. So having a plane like the F-15 carrying them makes better sense. The EX might be able to carry 3 or 4 such missiles, while still retaining most of its fuel tanks and speed dash capability. Such very long-range missiles would likely be used against unsuspecting non-stealthy fighters and force multiplier platforms like AWACS and tanker planes. Also, having a previous generation fighter jet mixed with stealthy jets might be the most optimal use of resources, as not all planes in a fight will get to be positioned forward. Having more visible planes might even be beneficial, as it might draw the enemy towards them and thus reveal themselves, perhaps enabling the stealthy part of the mixed force to engage those enemy forces. Indeed, the Chinese example is telling. They seem to be producing their J-20 stealth fighter in annual numbers approaching or surpassing the F-22 annual production. Yet at the same time, they're producing just as many large advanced flanker family fighters to augment their J-20 force, both with numerous medium-range missiles and very long-range missiles thrown into the mix. Faced with ever-increasing costs and new capability requirements not suited to stealthy fighters, the US Air Force does seem set on using their new Eagles for decades more. The Eagle II, despite its family's age, seems to have a bright future, one that will include outliving the F-22 Raptor.